The discussion now shall be on how do you generate Fibonacci sequence in a range. Suppose I say my input number lower range is 10 and upper range is 50, so it should only print 13, 21 and 34. Suppose my lower range is 0 and upper range is 30, then it should print 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21 and so on. When I had done this algorithm, I had purposely not taken care of 0 and 1 because that is the starting point of the sequence. But a couple of students were interested to know why we have not included 0, 1 in the sequence. So this logic has been very little modified so that you are able to even get the sequence starting from 0. So you can get 0, 1, 1, 2, 3 and so far. So in order to calculate the Fibonacci sequence, I require two variables R1 and R2 to give me the lower and upper range respectively. Then I am going to call a function called as Fibo underscore range, where the values of R1, the lower bound and the upper bound, are going to be passed. This Fibo range fellow is a function of the type void. It is not returning any value except that it is accepting two integers as parameters. So let's type in Fibo range. So I'm going to say void Fibo range stands for Fibonacci sequence in a range. So let's say this is int. Let's keep the name as same, because although the names are same, they're actually referring to two different memory locations. So if you change the values of R1 and R2 here in Fibo range, they are not going to get affected in the main. Now what I'm trying to do here is I'm defining the variable called as first. Okay, first is equal to 0 because the first value in the Fibonacci sequence is 0. If you see, the second is equal to 1. And in view of the special case where I want to even given the range from 0, I want to print that also. So I'm ensuring that I'm taking the value of next as 0. Then how long should I need to continue to print this series? As long as the value of next is less than or equal to the upper bound. And now once I get into the loop, I'm going to do an if condition. If the value of next is greater than or equal to the lower range, from then on I want to start printing the value of next. So I'm going to say printf %d space and next. Okay, I'll explain this once I complete the typing. Now the rest of the logic is very similar to what we have done in the algorithm. So to get a detailed understanding of the logic of the Fibonacci sequence, please take a look at the description section of this video where links are provided for the Fibonacci sequence generation. So first what I am doing is I am saying first should take the value of second, because next time first becomes second, and second should take the value of next. All right, and finally next should simply be the sum of first plus second. All right, so this is what happens, and then I close the parenthesis. Void, because it's not returning any data type. Int R1 and R2 are the two parameters for this particular function. So let's try to explain this with a very simple range. Let us say I want to print from, just say I want to print from 0, 1, 1, and let's say 2, 3 and 5. All right, let me say we want to just print these three numbers. Let's say the lower range is 0, upper range is just say 5 for simplicity. R1 is 0, R2 is 5. These are the initial values of first, second and next. Now what was the value of next? Next is 0. 0 is less than or equal to 5 for sure. Now is 0 greater than or equal to 0? R1 was 0, so we are fine. So let me make the value of R1 and R2 clear here. R1 is equal to 0, R2 is equal to 5. So 0 is less than or equal to 5, 0 is greater than or equal to 0. So I'm going to print 0. So the first time it's going to end up printing the value 0. First became second, second became next. So let's try to keep another place where I can get you the values of first and second. So first became second, in the sense second was 1 and second became next. So second ends up becoming 0. And what happens to next? Next ends up becoming 1, first plus second. So next time when I come, next 1 is less than or equal to 5 and 1 is greater than or equal to 0. So I'm going to print 1 the next time. All right. Now what happens to first? First takes the value of second, which is 0. Second takes the value of next, which is 1. Now next is again first plus second, which is again 1. So 1 is less than or equal to 5. 1 is greater than or equal to 0. So I am printing the next time one more 1. Now what has happened is first becomes the second, which is 1. Second becomes next, which is also 1. So nothing changes here. And next becomes first plus second 2. Now when I go back here, 2 is still less than or equal to 5. 2 is greater than or equal to 0, true. So I am going to print 2. Once I print 2 here, first is going to be second. So it remains 1. Second is going to be next, which becomes 2. Now this for next is first plus second ends up becoming 3. 3 is still less than or equal to 5. I am going to come here and I am going to print 3 because 3 is greater than or equal to 0. First becomes second. So now this chap becomes 2. Second becomes next, which becomes 3. And this becomes 5. 5 is still equal to 5. 0 is 5 is greater than or equal to 0 is true. So it's going to go ahead and print 5. Now what has happened is first has become 3. Second has become 5. This chap ends up becoming 8. Now the problem is 8 is not less than or equal to 5. I am going to come back and come back here. So the key parts to understand is this void indicates Fibo range is not returning any value. The two parameters being passed R1 and R2 are of the data types integer. R1 gets copied into this R1, R2 gets copied into this R2. Although the names are same, this R1 and R2 is local to main. Okay, and this R1 and R2 is local to Fibo range. So if you change the value of R1 and R2 here, it's not going to get changed in main. So in order to convince you on that, we will do it when we're running it. We will try to change the value of R1 and R2. So what I will do is I'll make R1 equal to 0 and I'll make R2 equal to also 0. Okay, so if I try to print R1 and R2 in main, it should not print 0 and 0. It should print the old values of R1 and R2. So let me print the values of R1 in main. I'll just say in main, R1 is equal to %d, R2 is equal to %d. All right. So in main, R1 is equal to some value, R2 is equal to some value, and I can give the value of R1 and R2. This will help you convince that the R1 and R2 in main are not the same as R1 and R2 in the calling function. So let's copy this particular piece of program. Let's copy it to our favorite online GDB compiler and try to compile it first. Let's see if there are any compilation errors. Okay, so far so good. Typing has been great. So let's try to enter the range. Let me start with 0 and let me enter 5. So it should print 0, 1, 1, 2, 3 and 5. So here if you see, it has ended up printing 0, 1, 1, 2, 3 and 5. Now in main, if you have seen, the value of R1 has remained 0, R2 has remained 5. Although I tried to make R1 and R2 as both 0 in the function Fibo range, it did not get affected in the main because R1 and R2 in main are totally different memory locations and totally different variables from R1 and R2 in Fibo range. That is important when we are learning pointers to remember this particular fact. So I hope you have understood this particular problem. Pardon me. Let's try to run it for a larger range. Let's try to run it from 1 to 1000. So it should print 1 twice and it should go to the rest of the thing again. So here if you see, it's again done it as expected. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 34, 55, 89, 144, 233, 377, 610, 987. Now again you see, in main, the value of R1 is 1 and R2 is 1000. Although I did try to change it here, it has had no effect in main because they are two different memory locations. R1, R2 here are local to Fibo range. The R1, R2 here are local to main function.